guys. Okay, so what are we doing today? So today we need to actually set up the build pipelines for the API server, because what I'd like to do is I'd like to get the build pipeline in place so that we can then have the migration in that build pipeline as part of the process. So today we're going to be working with Azure Pipelines. So we're going to click on Create Container Registry and we're going to see what it does. So again, there's a subscription. We're going to need a resource group. So Quirk Dev Service is probably the resource group that we would want this to be a part of because it's with the services. The registry name in this case could be, I guess it would just be Quirk Dev. We'd be in West. Availability zones, we're not going to worry about. Azure Container Registry Service protects your data at rest. Container Registry encrypts your images and other artifacts that are published. Customer managed key is, oh yeah, that's fine. So we know that we can automate this. So let's go ahead and before we move anywhere forward, let's go back to Azure DevOps because we have some automation to be done. Now we can actually do this automation in Quirk because this is a part of Quirk. Remember, we have two projects. We have our organizational project, Alt-F4 LLC, and then we have our product projects. And so the main thing about this that I want to point out is if I go to Lucid app, I can show you a quick little diagram on what all of this means. What this flowchart is going to show you guys is how I manage infrastructure, either security-wise, as well as just like where all the code goes. So at the end of the day, I really do want to be able to make it so that I can automate as much as humanly possible. But I also want to make it to where I can't just like let, you know, anybody, you know, just remove repositories or like really important things need to be abstracted away as so that other things can use those things. All right, so here we go. So we're going to say create a registry per environment for services. Priority is high, we need it. Risk is low. So I'm going to hit save and close. Okay, so let's create the container registry. So again, with Azure DevOps, I can also create branches. So I'm going to click create branch, not on the service, but on Terraform because I want to work with the Terraform repository. And we're going to call this feature container registry. Create container registry, main Terraform. Okay, cool. Create branch. So Terraform, we'll do get fetch. And there's our branch. Checkout dash B feature container registry. Okay. We're going to create a file called container registry.tf. Grab this, paste this in. What we want is we want the local workspace and that'll be the name of it. The resource group in this one will be service location will be the standard. I think we're good though. I use Terraform cloud. And so once I push that up and then I go to pull request, I should see there's my feature container registry, create pull request for it, assign it to myself. It's already attached to the user story, which is what we want. Hit create. Right now, it should be triggering pipelines in Terraform Cloud. Go to pull request. You can see both of them ran properly. So we're going to go ahead and complete this. We're going to squash this commit. So now you can see here, you see this in progress right here. That means that if I go to workspaces, see planning, I'm planning in dev now. So it's basically going to rerun that plan one more time. It's going to say, hey, does this look good to you? One to add, one to change, which is fine. What we want is the container registry created. That's what we want. And I'm going to hit confirm and apply. And I'm going to hit confirm. In a few moments, we should see the container registry pop up. As a matter of fact, I should be able to actually get out of this. There it is. So it got applied. It was created. And so if I go here, there it is. Okay. It just took a moment. Okay, cool. All right. So you can see here, Quirk Dev Registry has now been created. It's in the Quirk Dev Service Group, which is in West US, and it's attached to my Alt-F4 LLC subscription. Perfect. We needed this registry so that we could set up the pipelines. We're going to go to create pipeline. We're going to create, click that, click API, and then we're going to say an existing one, and we're going to get it from the feature migrate, and we're going to get it from the Azure Pipelines file itself. We're going to hit continue. Here it is right here. So I just do run. Okay. Here's my job. Did it approve us? Let's edit the pipeline. Edit. If we go back here, leave here, default, agents, agent pools, Azure pipelines, agents, hosted agent pools, default, agents. Let's go into here. We're going to edit this. We're going to change this to back to this. And then the pool is going to be Alt-F4 LLC. And then I'm going to commit it, feature migrate, fix CI, use self-hosted pool. Get rid of this. Default. Let's go to our pipelines. Hey, look at it, chat. There we go. Okay, permission granted. Let's click on the job. We got it. Okay, so this is something else that we need. So we need task script. This is a task called Docker installer. So basically what we're going to do is we're going to first say, hey, run the Docker installer because we need the CLI to install before we can actually do anything. Then we want the Docker build and push. So we're going to say container registry in this case is going to go to Quirk Dev. The container repository is going to be API. We're going to say build and push, build context, add pipeline to metadata, add base image metadata to images, and add. And there you go. Now we've got our second one. Now, what we want to do from here is we'll just leave this like this. So we're going to log into ACR, and this connection should be quirk dev. The next thing we want to do is build and push. We're going to call this API, and the tags in this case will be, can I do it like this? Like, can I actually just do like boom? And then for now, we'll just leave it like this. I'll delete it. Feature, migrate, pull default, task docker, login to ACR, login, quirk dev, right? Quirk dev. And then tags will be build ID. So I'll have a build ID and it'll also get tagged as the build branch source name. CLI, Azure Docker CLI installer, version. Remember we're on this one, CE, add here. Okay, so now we've got the installer as well. So we'll get rid of this and we'll go right here and we'll say task CLI, sure, add, and then copy and vim, and here do this and that. Okay, so here's the pipeline. Hey, look at that, there's our new container. Click on this Docker installer, build and push. You can see 718 megabytes. It's not taking any CPU resources though. It worked. Oh, dude, it worked. First try. Holy smokes. I'm not going to lie. I was not expecting it to work that easily. So now that that's done, we're a little bit, now we can just fly, chat. Now we can genuinely just fly. So we'll do nvim dockerfile, get rid of the transpile here since these are all essentially going to be in the same space. And then here's our actual final base layer right here. So this is the base layer right here, chat. So we've got this, and then you can see this is the final layer, essentially. Node 14.7.3, transpile, npmrc, npm install, npm run script build, and then rm-rf.npmrc. So I need all of this as well. So we'll do this. We'll paste this in. Get rid of this. This is going to be, delete all that. We can just do this. We'll call it as service. Yeah, as service. And then the node m production, work dev service. We're going to do the same thing here. Package.json, install. Okay, so then we'll go here. And this isn't this. This is this. So this should be just this now. There we go. So this should move this to here, and then this should be, it should be that, or it should be this. Probably going to be that, actually, dist in, yeah. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is this nodeenv. We want this nodeenv to be our environment, our workspace environment, like dev, whatever. We don't want this to be something else. And so what we're going to do now is we're actually going to go back to pipelines, edit, variables. Here we go, new variable. And so this variable is going to be workspace, and we're going to call it dev. This is not a secret, and we're not going to let it be overridable. So again, this is going to match technically the TF workspace. So this will be this will match the Terraform workspace. Terraform workspace equals quirk dev. Cool. So now I should be able to do this. And so what we're going to do is here, we're going to call it arg terraform workspace. This env will be terraform workspace. See that? So I'm going to pass down from the CLI terraform workspace, and I'm going to use it as a node environment so that when this runs, if I had like logs, I could basically see quirk-dev in the logs for the environment or for the node env. And I am going to make this dev, just because I think it makes more sense for that. Okay, so I'm gonna save it, and there you go. So now I have Terraform workspace equals quirk dev. And so now my node environment is different from production, which is fine, but I'm still running a production install here. And that's what I wanted to essentially achieve. I just wanted to make it so that if I needed to do that, I could. Node module. We don't want node modules to be added ever. Azure pipelines, we don't need that. Azure pipelines.yaml. So get node modules, don't need get, don't need node modules, don't need, or we need source, we don't need Azure pipelines. We obviously don't need the Docker file itself. Again, some of this is not necessary. I'm just being explicit here. Get ignore, that's fine. npmrc, so that needs to be copied in, which means I can't ignore it. But yeah, this one I can get rid of, nvmrc, orm config. Okay, so I think this is pretty good, chat, right? We don't need Git. We don't need node modules. We don't need Azure pipelines. We don't need a Docker file. I think this is pretty much everything. All I want to be able to do now, chat, is after I do an NPM install, do copy and then source destination, just do the good old fashioned dot dot. And so, yeah, this is basically going to make it so that I have my installs cached, and it is going to recopy my package.json on my shrink wrap. Like, it is going to redo that, but like, it's fine. It's just going to overwrite it. So basically what should happen now is it should grab node 1417.3 Alpine. It should then do the install that we need it to, set up the npmrc, do the install, run the actual script to build. Now, actually, you know what I could do for this? Instead of doing this, we could call this source. I could actually call this directory source and rename it so that now, instead of this being dist, it could just be service source index.js, and we don't have really any kind of dist idea. It's just it exists for a moment, and then we rename it to source. Essentially, we have finally gotten to the point where essentially this was Quirk is essentially existed as a big mono repo for a long time. It was a mono repo, and so one of the things we had to do is we had to take each service, or what we're gonna have to do is take each service and literally pull it out of the mono repo. So you'll see like API, cron, Discord bot, these are all services. But if you look here, we had this shared service, and this isn't actually a service. It is the only unique folder in this whole thing because it is a shared library. And this shared library was something that is being used across all of these services. But because we're not using a mono repo, one of the things we had to do was we had to turn this into an Azure artifact. And so if I actually take a step back and I go to Quirk and I go to artifacts, Azure has this thing called feeds. And essentially what a feed allows you to do is set up your own repository or registry or whatever you need to cache the packages that your app uses. And so for example, you'll see here that my feed also has upstreams of NuGet, PyPy, Maven Central. Now I don't need any of these, so I can actually just go ahead and delete all three of these and just keep NPM because that's all I need. And now this will always grab from NPM, cache it, save it, and then I can run off of this. Not only can I do that, but I can also publish my own packages to it. And so you can see here, I have Quirk service, and this Quirk service is literally the service package that was once called shared. So now we're at the point where we've got our databases, we've got our cache instance, we've got everything we need, and all we need to do now is start deploying containers. Right now, I'm literally in the process of wrapping up the Docker file here. The thing on the left, this file on the left, is the Azure pipeline definition. But essentially what this does is this tells Azure, hey, on my feature migrate branch, I want to use my pool, which is my default. And I actually even showed you guys how to set up a local Azure DevOps runner. And so what you'll see here is I actually have a couple different containers running on my computer right now. I have a YAML language server because I'm working with YAML. I have a Docker language server because I'm working with Docker files. But then you'll also see a Docker agent here. And this Docker agent is literally, if I go here, go to organization settings, go to agent pools, default, and then I go to agents, Alt F4 LLC. It's this service right here, Alt F4 LLC. It's this literal agent. So I have my own local running agent that I'm using with Azure DevOps. So for this branch, what happens is if we go back to our Docker agent and we look at the compose, you're gonna see that I have a volume here called var run Docker stock, which then mounts var run Docker stock. But yeah, you can see here that I'm actually mounting my Docker socket on my current host into the container. And the reason for that is because it doesn't actually install Docker. It just installs the CLI and then runs that version against my daemon. What's cool about Docker is Docker has all of its versions of its API available to it in the endpoint itself. So for example, this 1709 version is going to call a specific API version, and it's okay because all of those versions are available in the API itself. And yeah, I think we're good. All right, so let's go ahead and see. We'll say feature CI add Docker build tasks and push. Now, once I push, what should happen is I should immediately go into CTOP and see a new container appear here in the next few moments. And so if I go to Quirk and then I go to pipelines, we can see, yep, API is running. Click on this. Okay. And so, yep, there's our new container. There you go. It's running other tasks as it's going through. And so now it's actually doing npm CI to install all of the packages. There we go. All of that ran. We're good to go. 654 packages installed. And then we copy everything. And now we do npm run script build. And so you can see here, delete, and then npx tsc pretty. Hey, look at that. The build worked. And log out. So this should finish. Log out, post job, finalize job. We're almost there. We're almost there. Cool. Okay, so we did it. We did it. There you go. Job, success. 1 minute and 28 seconds. But chat, we just did it. We just had our first Docker container build. That was it. It's right here. It worked. It 100% worked. We were able to install the CLI, log into Docker, authenticate our NPM, actually build it, and install all of the packages that we needed it to, and then log out, which you can see here, we were able to log out, and then, yeah, finish the job. So, yeah, we did it.